the latest Siemens NX2312, has significant changes in NX CAM. Today, we're taking a look at, in my opinion, a substantial update concerning the so-called Z-level undercut operation. What exactly that is and how it affects the current planar profile operation, you'll find out in today's video. My name is Heinrich Flaum, and I warmly welcome you to my video from JANUS Engineering.
So let's take a look at our part now. As we can see, we have an undercut in here, not just a simple slot geometry, but also in a freeform manner. Well, previously, we would have to pick one kind of a tool, and the tool was called a freeform, or better said, user-defined tool that has that shape to manufacture that cutout in here. Not just that, we also had to use one specific operation, and the operation was planar profiling in order to use the so-called freeform mill. That is no longer necessary. Instead, I will simply go to mill contour and pick the new operation that's called Z-level undercut. I also will pick my tool for that and click on OK. In this dialog, I also can set the cut pattern instead of Z-level zig. I would like to have it in a Z-level zigzag manner. And the depth per cut is supposed to be 0.5 millimeters. The next thing that I will define is the cut area. So that means I will simply pick on any face that are within the undercut, just like that. Click on OK. The next thing is to set the tool axis. I will specify the tool axis to be it in this way, according to my face up here. Well, that's actually it. Let me generate this operation now. Okay, there we go. And now we see that the user-defined tool is manufacturing this undercut on our part, stepwise. Good. The cool thing about this operation, though, is we are not limited to undercuts, even though the operation is called undercut. For now, I would like to manufacture this radius of my part. For that, I also have already a user-defined tool existing, this radius cutter. How do I proceed in here? First of all, I repeat the steps, right-click, insert an operation. I'm going once more to the Z-level undercut section and pick my new tool, accept with OK. Just like before, I would like to have it in a Z-level zig manner now. The depth per cut is supposed to be 6 millimeters, just the depth of the radius. The next thing is the geometry. I will pick the radius face. Okay. Last but not least, I will go to tool axis and define the tool axis to be just like before, upwards from that face. So what happens when I generate the operation now? Okay, we now have a tool path, but as we see, it's not just one single way around the part. It's separated into three different steps. How can I change that? For that, I will go to cut levels, and in the range type, instead of automatic, I simply will say it to be single. We generate the operation again. And now we see that the operation is being done with one single path along the radius of our part with my user defined, or better said, freeform end mill. Good. So how does all those operations look now in the machine simulation context? For that, let me start the simulation. As the post-processor now has created all the NC code, we can slow down a little bit and hit the play icon. Now we see the very first operation going to the part and begins its milling. So let me speed up the simulation speed in here. And by the way, if you're interested in how you can improve the performance of your simulation even more, check out on this I to see for more information on that. And last but not least, we also have our radius cutter in here as well.
Here we are then. The previous limitation of freeform or user-defined tools to the planar profile operation type is now a thing of the past. So we can now use the open source tools in a surface-based operation as well. And the best part, we can push this operation even further than its original purpose. Keyword here is the shoulder radius mill. We are, of course, waiting for more operations that allow us to use the tools freely. If there are any innovations, we will, of course, release a video about it. And to make sure you don't miss it, it's worth subscribing right here. Until then, feel free to watch one of our many NX videos. Until next time, bye.
Let's make it real. JANUS Engineering.